Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Today's video is how to create an opportunities and constraint diagram in Photoshop. So let's get started. So now there are three ways to start creating this diagram. First of all, you can have your site drawn in AutoCAD and then you add that in Photoshop and then you select everything and then you add the colors. The second option is to use Google Maps and from there you can do the exact same steps, although you won't get layers, so you'll have to divide it into layers. Now, I wasn't feeling really well that day, so I decided to take the quick and easy way, and I've used Digimap to export different layers of the site and then add them into Photoshop to create the diagram. So the first thing that I did is I got rid of the watermark, and if you are using Digimap, the easiest way I found to get rid of the watermark is to use the color range and then, for example, select the water and then you inverse the selection, and then from there you can delete the watermark. And I did that for all of the layers. It took less than 2 minutes, I think, and it was good to go. So then afterwards, I've added in my color palette, which if you haven't seen my previous video, is all about how to create your color palette. So that's the color palette I'm going for. So I'm adding the gray color overlay to the buildings. And then after that, colored over the buildings and merged it with the surface layer so that it's all one clean surface. You guys know how much I'm a big advocate for Skillshare, and I'm so excited to be recommending this class by Steven Rubio, also known as the iconic Show It Better channel on YouTube. In this class, Steven shares his knowledge and a step-by-step tutorial to creating this image, starting from SketchUp all the way to the final image. If you don't know what Skillshare is, it is basically an online learning community with thousands of classes on design, business, and more. It is so amazing to expand on your current interests or talents, or to deepen your knowledge of things you are interested in. It is also affordable, as the annual subscription is less than $10 a month. I will also have a link below that gives you 2 months of free premium access to however many classes you are interested in. It will only be available to the first 1,000 that click the link, so do check it out if you're looking to develop your personal and creative skills. And now I'm adding colors into the water and then the green space, so all using the palette. And then afterwards, I'm gonna erase the buildings on my site, and it's really easy to do that since everything is on layers exported from Digimap. So if you are doing this from AutoCAD, make sure you also export everything in layers, so it'll make this diagram a lot easier to make. So now I'm also adding a drop shadow to the water just to give it a bit of depth. And then Digimap didn't recognize that this is green space, so I had to select it in some way to try and color that in. So I'm gonna do it really messy, and then I can select the roads and then delete it afterwards. So I'm also adding concrete texture to the surface just to give it a bit of texture. And I'm using this diagram for inspiration for the color palette, as well as like the overall style of the diagram. It's by a firm called Hall McKnight. You should definitely check out their diagrams. I'm actually shook. I haven't seen anything like them before, and I really like them. They're all desaturated. So if you like this image, I'll leave the link to the firm in the description box for you if you want to check that out. I'm also coloring in the surface with like a beige color, and then I'm adding a grass texture to the green space using the pattern overlay. And then I'm also gonna add grass images on top and then add that using a clipping mask. Why I'm adding a second texture for the grass is because I want the grass to look patchy. So then using the black brush, I can then erase some areas and make it a bit patchy. adjust the hues and saturation to bring the saturation down so that it all matches with each other. If you are, for example, doing a location map, all you'll need to do is just add the red boundary. And I've seen this trick in another video, which is adding that vintage grain to your images. So all you'll have to do is press Ctrl Shift Alt and E, and that stamps all of the layers onto a new layer. And then you convert that into a smart object, go into filter, camera raw filter, and then if you click on the FX, kind of reminds me of math, you know, the FX function. I miss math. So now if you adjust the amount, size, and roughness, so play around with it, test out how it looks. So now if you're not doing a location map and you're doing the opportunities and constraint diagram, you can then delete that layer and we'll get back to it when we're done. So I'm going to add a stroke to my site and I'm going to select that with the magic wand tool and then add a gray color overlay and then stroke. And even the stroke is from the color palette. So once you create your palette, everything has to be within that palette to create a cohesive look within your presentation boards. So now another thing that I liked about the diagram is how simple the trees were. It was literally just a circle with different shades of green and with a low opacity and a white stroke. So then you can see how these trees overlap each other with the white stroke. And I think it looks really nice and is actually a lot easier than getting a PNG from Google or any other site. So now I'm going to add some symbols to the opportunities and constraint diagram. I usually take them from Google, but one of my friends actually on YouTube, the Architectural Insider, if you haven't watched this video yet, go check it out. I absolutely hate doing this diagram, but he made me feel like it was really easy with that video. He found this image from Pinterest and it has all kinds of different symbols. And then I added that into my diagram and then deleted everything that is white by selecting everything that's black in the color range and then select inverse and then delete everything. And then afterwards, I also added a color overlay to make sure that nothing was black and it was gray. So I'm adding this zigzag line to represent noise and it's mainly coming from the main streets and train line. So these arrows are, for example, vehicle access and also connections. So now I'm going to add my master plan on top because I want to select the buildings. I want it to be relatively to scale, but not necessarily perfect. Select all of the buildings in the master plan and add a color overlay. And I also have this linked loop, so I'm also going to add a color overlay to that. Select everything from the master plan and just add a color overlay to that. Add some text. So then we're gonna change this into this vintage look by pressing Ctrl Shift Alt and E. You go into filter, camera raw filter, and then you adjust the grain. And that is the end of the diagram. I hope you guys enjoyed it and you found it helpful. Let me know in the comments down below what Skillshare classes have you watched lately. I've watched Real Productivity by Thomas Frank. I've also watched Productivity Masterclass, also by Thomas Frank, because as you can see, I have a habit of procrastinating, so I need to be productive. And I've also watched two classes for calligraphy. I've watched another class for hand lettering, digital lettering, block lettering, and then also hand lettering essentials for beginners because I wanted to improve just how I write. I've also watched design thinking, art hacks to overcome creative block, the perfect 100 day project, your guide to explosive creative growth. So let me know in the comments down below what Skillshare classes have you watched. I hope you have an amazing day. I'm Rasha Shururu and I'll see you next time.